Hello viewers, welcome to JSM. In previous videos, I have explained SP hybridization, SP2 hybridization, SP3 hybridization, along with that SP3D, SP3D2 hybridizations completed. In this video, I am going to explain SP3D3 hybridization. What is SP3D3 hybridization? One s orbital, 3 p orbitals and 2 d orbitals combines to give total 7 sp3d3 hybrid orbitals. 7 sp3d3 hybrid orbitals known as sp3d3 hybridization. Known as sp3d3 hybridization. Here, one s orbital, 3 p orbitals and 2d orbitals combines to give how many total? 7 sp3d3 hybrid orbitals. 7 sp3d3 hybrid orbitals. First orbital, second orbital, third orbital, fourth orbital, fifth orbital, sixth orbital and seventh orbital. So these are hybrid orbitals. So what is the shape of hybrid orbital? Shape of hybrid orbital is a pentagonal bipyramidal. Shape is a pentagonal bipyramidal. What is the bond angle? It is the bond angle between these two. Bond angle is 90 degrees and between these two bond angle is 72 degrees. So now in other ways, here it is a okay. So first hybrid orbital, second hybrid orbital, third, fourth, fifth hybrid orbital, this is sixth hybrid orbital and this is the seventh hybrid orbital. So what is the bond angle? Here it is the bond angle between these two is 90 degrees. Between these two is, it is 72 degrees. So what is the shape? Shape is pentagonal bipyramidal. Let us take one example. Here example is IF7, iodine heptafluoride. In this iodine heptafluoride, the central element is iodine. Its outermost electronic configuration is 5s2 5p5. So now here 5s2 5p5, 1 2 3 4 5. Okay, we know that in this energy level, availability of d orbital is there. So this is known as what? Ground state electronic configuration. We know that 7 fluorines are there. Here we must have how many? 7 unpaired electrons. So that which process? Excitation. If I give energy to this orbital, electrons are getting energy and excited into orbitals. So that is the process is known as what? Excitation. Same, if I give energy to this orbital, this is the electron excited into d orbital. Here excited state electronic configuration, is first electron excited. So now this is known as what? First excited state electronic configuration. Same, if we give energy to this, this is the electron excited into d orbital. So which one? Second electron is exciting. So now this is known as what? Second excited state electronic configuration. So now here second excited state electronic configuration is 1 2 3 and in this d orbital we have two electrons. So now same, if we give energy to this, this is the electron excited into d orbital. Okay, so now which one? Third electron is exciting, so it is known as what? Third excited state electronic configuration. Third excited state electronic configuration. So now here it is, the excited state electronic configuration is 1 2 3 1 2 3. Okay, what is the hybridization? sp3 d3. So now 1 s orbital, 3 p orbitals and 3 d orbitals. Okay, 1 s orbital, 3 p orbitals and 3 d orbitals. What is the hybridization? sp3 d3. How many total? 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. 7 sp3 d3 hybrid orbitals. 7 sp3 d3 hybrid orbitals. Okay, na? So now once we know hybrid orbitals, already we know what is that? The hybrid orbital structure is what? Pentagonal bipyramidal. So now I am arranging hybrid orbitals of iodine. Okay, first hybrid orbital, second hybrid orbital, third hybrid orbital, fourth hybrid orbital and fifth hybrid orbital, next sixth and seventh hybrid orbital. So each hybrid orbital having one unpaired electron. So this is the arrangement of hybrid orbitals in iodine. Okay, we know that second element is what? Fluorine. Okay, so fluorine, we know that fluorine, atomic number 9, electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p, 5. So this is outermost electronic configuration 2s2, 2p, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So px, py, pz. So in which orbital? In pz orbital we have what? One unpaired electron. Okay, so now here how many fluorines are there? 7. Here, so that here we are getting 7 pz orbitals. So now 7 pz orbitals of fluorine linearly overlaps with hybrid orbitals, of iodine, so that here 7 sigma bonds are forming. So now I am taking p orbitals of fluorine, first p orbital, okay, second p orbital, third p orbital, fifth p orbital, sixth p orbital, and seventh p orbital. So now what is the geometry? Is pentagonal bipyramidal. Okay, so all are sigma bonds. So for our convenience I am showing like this. Here okay, here it is iodine 1 2 3 4 5. This is sixth one. So now here it is a seventh one. Okay, so right here it is a fluorine. Okay, so what is the bond angle? Here it is the bond angle is, here bond angle is 90 degrees, here bond angle is 72 degrees. So now here it is what? Pentagonal bipyramidal. So bipyramidal structure is like this. So this is above and below is also same. pentagonal bipyramidal. Pentagonal bipyramidal. So this is the structure of IF7, iodine heptafluoride with sp3d3 hybridization.